Today is 7th July. In East Africa or Swahili speaking areas, we call it Saba Saba Day. Saba Saba is a day of significance. I will talk of it in three aspects. The first one is when the Tanzanian ruling party, the then TANU, Tanzania African National Union, was started on 7th July. I think it's also a workers' day in Tanzania. And TANU later merged with the Afro Shirazi to start the Chama cha Mapinduzi. It has significance in Tanzania, and also the UN, UNESCO, came and recognized it as International Swahili Day. So Saba Saba Day is also the International Swahili Day, to honor the Swahili language. I remember on Saba Saba Day in 1990, which will form now the major component of today's recording, the duty officer was the late Chief Inspector Chansu Virili. Chansu Virili was the duty officer that day, but he turned to me and told me to be the duty officer on that day, which I did. You know, being those who know the police, there is some duties which are allocated to members of inspectorate and members of the superintendency. At the desk in the province, duty officers were members of the inspectorate. So Chansu Virili was to be the duty officer that day, but he requested me to be the duty officer that day, and then he went to Kamukunji. You can remember that during that day, James Orengo, Martin Shikuku, among others, went around in a pickup which had public address, and they used to say, "Tukutane Kamukunji, tukutane Kamukunji." But if you can recall the picture so well, you'll notice that all of them were heavily dressed. They were putting on a vest, shirt, and a sweater and a coat, and a heavy coat. Why were they doing that? They were doing that because they knew that they'll be arrested and they'll go to the cells. So they were going with the heavy clothing so that when they are in the cells, it will assist to ward off the cold. At least you can now understand why. If you come across a picture of them on top of the pickup with heavy clothing, that was that. Now we'll start. There was a meeting at Car General House along Moi Avenue, where Anyona and Gadhangu had approached Matiba. They approached Matiba to recruit him into forming a second political party. The political party that they had in mind was Kenya National Congress. Kenya National Congress. But they did not fail to tell him to be very careful with his activities, because Moi would arrest him and detain him. But for some reason, and that reason is the one which made Matiba have several strokes, I think two, in detention, is that Matiba believed that he had a special influence on Moi, that Moi could not detain him. He really believed that in his body. He just felt that he could say anything, he could do anything. He was untouchable as far as Moi was concerned. But Matiba was wrong. This is what we say, that you do not see the clouds. Eh? It will rain on you. The same Matiba knows that Moi had demoted Kibaki from vice president to minister for health. Even he himself had been harassed in Kano, but somehow he tended to believe, and he even told them that Moi can't arrest me, Moi can't detain me. I think that one must have contributed to his stroke. And you see, there are those people who are used to sales life. But for a person like Matiba, a self-made billionaire, now going to sleep on a bare floor, going to being in a room where there is your own human waste there, which is picked once a day, and such a thing, maybe you understand why he had a stroke. The founders of Kenya National Congress included Isaiah Ngotho, David Oyugi, Karioki Gathitu, used to be called Karis, Anyona, and Gathango. Nyachai was still in the government, but he was a heavy hitting. He used to criticize the government from within the government. He used to finance, he used to buy large space advertisement in newspapers, criticizing things in the government. Onajua Wakisi. Wakisi, I've got two options of Nyasore. Either the Nyasore he is doing is one that his parents used to use before he was born, na ikaingia kwa blood, or part two is that Mukisi has that Nyasore that he inherited and he has added another Nyasore. These people can decide to be unreasonable. So Nyachai would just do that, throwing caution to the wind. Yes, people like Raila and so on joined later. Actually, Raila was to join KNC, but he went to join it later. But then it so happened that a few days before Saba Saba, that was on 3rd July 1990, Matiba, Raila, and Rubia were arrested and detained. So they were taken off. They didn't participate in Saba Saba. They were already behind bars. But then Njeru Gathangu and others had hired a house. You know, handling people, you remember in the weekend edition, I talked of how it is hard to get information from the Nakuru fellow, I'm forgetting his name. It is so hard to get information from him. But then it is harder to get information from a person like Njeru Gathangu, because this fellow was already a member of the armed forces. So matter of intelligence was really hard for intelligence people to get him. Gathangu hired a building near Kamukunji where he held a telescope and he was monitoring the place. And using his Akili Askari, he knew, he had already announced through leaflets that the meetings would start at 10 a.m. But he knew that the government would not offer a license. And he also knew that the government would block the place. So the trick was, let some youths play football there and the people pretend as if they are watching the football. And then they are watching the football, then the thing would itavimba mpaka ikue the meeting. itavimba paka ikuwe the meeting. That is what they had planned. So around noon, Njeru Gathangu was on this side of organizing things. That is when Kina Orengo, Kina Martin Shikuku, and others. And I think this Mumeru, the lawyer who was also a publisher, they hired a pickup. And you know, they hired the pickup and the owner did not know who. They hired through a third party. And then they went around town saying, Tukutane Kamukunji, Tukutane Kamukunji. And Njeru Gathangu had also organized for the busing in of people from outside Nairobi. On that day, 5,000 people arrested on the Kamukunji thing. So the thing went and started dying slowly because they had arrested. You know, 5,000 in that year, 1990, is equivalent to, 50,000 today, even more. So the thing went slightly down. Then Baraza la Wazee came in. Baraza la Wazee came in. Jaramogi Oginga, Martin Shikuku, and Muriro now came in and even recruited George Nthenge. They recruited George Nthenge, whom they said that now they'll push for multi-party. It was a deliberate thing that those days, Jaramogi was very old. Martin Shikuku was also getting old. Masinde Muriro was old, but not very. And George Nthenge was. So it was Baraza la Wazee. And it was tempting the government so that should they be arrested, then it would bring an international problem because of their age. And that is how those people started coming. And then those Wazees, now this one happened after 77. These Wazees are the ones who now came and formed FORD. They formed FORD because when Kenya National Congress could not be made, Jaramogi plus Salim Damwe plus others formed National Democratic Party. They formed a political party called National Democratic Party. But then the government, using Section 2A of the Constitution, which says that there shall only be one political party in Kenya, KANU. So they said that it is unconstitutional to register National Democratic Party. Remember, National Democratic Party is NDP, and Raila later on bought. Raila later, I don't know whether I can call it bought. He got it from Oluthe, but he never honored the promises that he had with Oluthe. So NDP, the first NDP was National Democratic Party by Jaramogi, and the second one was National Development Party by Oluthe, which Raila took over much, much later. So Jaramogi had his political party, which was not registered, and then they started FORD. Then the government, first of all, challenged Jaramogi by saying, how can you belong to two parties? You already have started something called NDP, and at the same time, you have started, you are the head of NDP, and at the same time, you are the head of FORD. And he said, FORD is not a political party, and FORD must be registered. FORD must be registered because Section 2A says no other political party will be registered. So NDP, yes, National Democratic Party, you are saying should not be there. Yeah, you cannot register it because of Section 2A. But you see, FORD is not a political party. That is, what do you call it? It is just like Kenya Human Rights Commission. Here happened in Valiakade. So it is a pressure movement, but it is not a political party. It should be registered under society. So that is when they started a forum for the restoration of democracy. And just like Kenyans, we are known, anything happening, we use that opportunity, like we had orange and banana, 2005 referendum. If bananas would have won, maybe someone would have formed a party called Banana Democratic Party. So when the country when that Section 2A was removed from the constitution, everybody now rushed to associate himself with Ford, which morphed from a pressure group into a political party and split into several occasions. That is in remembrance of Saba Saba, and it is a ripple effect. Thank you.